Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back, everyone. Today, inshallah, we'll fix some problems about frictional force. Okay. At the beginning, to understand and answer the problem about the coefficient of friction, it's very easy to understand. Let's answer this question number one, page 137. Okay. Now, he will explain this and he asked about this question, and we will turn back for the problem D. Okay. Now, he said that in the problem D, the horizontal force exerts 53 newtons, keeps the crate moving at constant velocity. Here we have very important point. Look over here for this point. Here he said that constant velocity. What does it mean? It means constant velocity, it means the acceleration equals zero and the net force in this case equals zero also, by the way. Okay, because that this object moves and the applied force equal to the fractional force, both of them the same, okay? Both of them the same. They are in the same magnitude and the opposite direction. And most of time, the gravitational force or the weight equal to the normal force, okay? This will be easy to understand, very easy to answer these problems, okay? Now, he said that 53 Newton keeps the moving and constant beat. It means the applied force here is 53 Newton, that is the applied force. Okay, now, and find the mu, okay, it means the kinetic coefficient of friction. He wants the kinetic coefficient of friction between crate and floor. Very easy to answer this problem, okay? Now, the formula is mu k equaled fk kinetic frictional force divided by the fn. Okay, of course, from the previous problem, you can see that M here or mass equaled to 24, and I said that before. If he gave you the mass, you should to multiply 9.8 to find the weight. Okay, now and here, of course, the normal force will be at the same magnitude of weight and in the opposite direction. Okay, because that we can see that here Fk equal to applied force and the normal force equal to weight. Okay, now frictional force or kinetic frictional force equaled 53 Newton divided by 24 times 9.8 Newton, okay, equaled at the end 0.22 without unit. That is the coefficient of friction for kinetic friction. Okay, and all the questions about the coefficient of friction, very easy to understand, very easy to answer, because he gave you in the net force equals zero most of time, and they are equals, and it will be very easy to understand. Let's move for the another kind of problems. In the another kind of problem, here the net force not equals zero, okay? What do you think? Why the net force not equal zero? I think because we have acceleration. When he said that we have object and he wants the acceleration, or he said that the object accelerate, it means the net force not equal zero. Okay, now let's move for this problem to understand more about that. Look over here, guys. Sample problem E, page 139. Okay, now here in this problem, let's draw this object at the beginning. Here in this problem, let's draw it. We have boy, and this boy will exert this box with 20 kilogram mass. Okay, and he will pull with force 90 Newton. Okay. He bolt with force 90 Newton, that is a 90 Newton, okay, in this direction. But we have here angle with 30 degrees, okay, 30 degrees, okay, with horizontal. The coefficient of kinetic friction between the box and a sidewalk is 0.500, okay. Now he gave you mu, okay, mu k here equals 0.500. 100. Okay, find the acceleration. He wants the acceleration. That is the point, guys. Now, in this case, here at the beginning, the applied force not equal the fractional force, not equaled. Why? Not equal the kinetic frictional force. Why? Because this object accelerates. In this case, F net not equal zero. Not equal zero, okay? And also here, the Fn, in this case, the Fn or the normal force, not equal to weight. Why? Because you have another force here exerting this object, okay? Because that, the weight equaled both of them with each other. Equal a normal force and another force here in Y, okay? We explain that now. That is the first point to understand. Now, the very important point to understand, when he asked you about acceleration or he gave you acceleration, it means this object accelerate. It means this object net force not equal zero. Okay, it means the applied force most of time will be bigger than the kinetic friction. I like that, guys. Okay, you should understand this point very well. Okay, now let's answer this problem. The first step is analyze 90 newton or the force with angle analyze into two components x and y. Okay, and we said that before x it will be the near of the or beside of the angle will be cosine and away from the angle will be sine. Okay, now we can see that here the if applied x, I mean the components x, it will become like that 90 cosine 30. Okay, 90 cosine 30 on x, that is the F applied x. Okay, what about F applied or applied force y component? Okay, it equals 90 sine 30. Okay, now that is the first step we will make it. We will look over and analyze 90 newton into two components, x and y, like that. That's the first step, okay? Now, let's take a look. What do you want? He wants that acceleration, okay? At the beginning, guys, we need the net force. F net or net force equals ma, okay? Now, we do not have F net because here F net not equals zero. And he wants a. He wants acceleration. And M, we have it, no problem. Now we want to find F net, or the net force, okay? Now, net force equaled what? Net force, okay, as you know that net force, F net, equaled applied force on X, F applied in the component X, negative Fk, it will become the F net. Okay, now F net equaled F applied or applied force in the X axis, okay, negative or negative of Fk, okay, or minus Fk, okay, that is net force. Okay, now here in this case we do not have Fk, okay, and we have F applied as well, as you see here. We have applied force here in X. Okay, now, we want to find Fk. Now, if you look over for Fk, Fk equaled equaled mu k, okay, times Fn. Mu k times Fn, we have mu k. We do not have Fn, because Fn in this case do not equal the weight. Okay, now the second step is find Fn. Okay, the second step is to find Fn. Okay, to find Fn, guys, now as you see here from this drawing, you can analyze that here Fn plus 90 newton, okay, or sorry, plus 90 sine, all of this, okay, 90 sine 30, that is all in Y. Fn plus F applied Y, 90 sine 30, okay, equaled weight, 20 times 9.8, okay, again this point, I will erase all of things here, I don't want you to confuse. Okay, now, here, again, on the y-axis, we have up here two things. We have normal force and 90 sine 30, that is applied force in y-axis. Okay, it will be upward like that. Downwards, we have the weight. Weight here become mass multiply 9.8, that is weight. Okay, that is weight. Okay, meter per second squared. Okay, now, and this one will become balanced with this one. They are balanced together. Okay, they are balanced together. Now, I will write that. I will write Fn plus 90 sine 30 balanced with 20 times 9.8. Just it. Okay, now, as you see here, we have all of them. We want to find Fn. We want to find Fn. Okay, now 90 sine 30, 9 sine 30 equals 45, and 20 times 9.8 equals 196. Okay, we can move this one in the other side by other sign. Now here Fn equals 196, negative 45, equals 151. Okay, I'll change the board to make it easier to look over. Okay, you can see it now better. Okay, now here that is Fn. Now we found Fn. Fn equal 151 newton. Okay, now let's come back here to find Fk. Okay, now this is the third step. Now we are in third step here, number three. Fk equal to mu k. Okay, Fn. Now we have Fk, he gave it to you. Yes, I think 0.500 times 151 equal, now Fk equaled with me 75.5 newton. That is fractional force. Now we will find the net force, number 4, F net equaled applied force in x, F applied in the x-axis, okay, negative Fk, that is the net force, negative Fk, okay. Now, applied force in x-axis, 90 cosine 30, okay, 90 cosine 30, okay, negative 75.5. Now, cosine, 90 cosine 30, 90 cosine 30, equaled with me 77.9, okay, and negative 75.5 equals 2.4. Now we can find A by this way. Now we have F net, we have M, we can find A very easy. Now A equaled F net 2.4 divided by M equal 20, A equal at the end is 0.12 meter per second squared. That is the way to answer the problems with when we have some of these force exerting the object in angle like that. You can use steps to understand this, and you can answer another problem to understand more about that. I hope you understand. Thanks a lot for watching. If you have any question, don't be late to ask me in WhatsApp or in comments down. Thanks a lot. See you next time, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum. Goodbye.